about the reduction formulas and then its application in finding the area, length, volume and the surface area. In case of the reduction formulas, basically we are going to deal with some important formulas like how to calculate integral of sine to power n dx. When we have to calculate integral of sine to power n, in this case normally if it is a odd or even function n, then easily we can calculate that, but in general how we have to reduce it is important. So what we are doing, we are supposing this is a integral, this n we associate with this one. Now we are writing this function as sine of n minus 1 x into sine x dx with the assumption that n must be greater than equal to 1. So if we are having this one, then we are writing it in this form. When we have this form, then it is equal to, now we are considering this as a first function and the second function, and when we are integrating it by considering first and second function, then it is integration of the first function, means integration of sin x, so it is cos x, into second function as it is, which is sin of n minus 1 x. Then we are taking a derivative of this function, means minus of n minus 1 times of, derivative of this is sin of n minus 2 x into cos x, and the integral of this is cos square x dx. This means we reduce the function sin n x in the form of, after integrating it comes out to be cos x into sin n minus 1 x by parts, means the integral of this first part and the integral of this one, minus of n minus 1 times of, derivative of this is sin n minus 2 x into cos square x dx, which comes out to be cos x into sin of n minus 1 x minus of n minus 1, and when we are writing cos square x, that comes out to be the 1 minus sin square x. So it will be sin of this, means in general our function becomes cos x into sin of n minus 1 x minus of n minus 1 times of sin n minus 2 x into 1 minus sin square. So if we are solving it, it comes out to be cos x into sin of n minus 1 x minus of, and when we are integrating it, it is sin of n minus 2 x dx, and the another term is plus of n minus 1 of sin of n x dx. Now if we are writing this in terms of this, so it comes out to be cos x into sin of n minus 1 x minus of n minus 1 of I n minus 2 and plus n minus 1 of I n. Now when we are combining with this, then it comes out to be, when we are bringing this on this side, then n of I n is equal to cos x into sin of n minus 1 x minus of, now when we are solving it, we got the formula directly as I n equal to cos x into of sin of n minus 1 x. So this is a reduction formula. This means in the one go we reduce the power by 2, and the formula becomes that the integral of sin to power n x becomes integral of sin n minus 2. This means in one formula or in one go we reduce the power by 2. So this is known as a reduction formula, and every time when we are reducing it by the two powers, in the last either we are getting a 0 power or a 1 power, and easily we are able to integrate that function. Now the most important use of this is how to calculate when it is having the limit, and that has the most of the application in most of the physical problems. So now our purpose is to calculate the reduction formula. This is in general the reduction formula. Now our purpose is to calculate the reduction formula if In is 0 to pi by 2. Then we know that In has this reduction formula. Now I am applying on this. So In is cos x into sin of n minus 1 x divided by n from 0 to pi by 2 minus of n minus 1 by n 0 to pi by 2 of sin n minus 2 x dx. So when we are applying this formula, then when we are taking a pi by 2, at pi by 2 cos value is 0 and at 0 sin value is 0. So this In comes out to be 1 minus 1 by n of In minus 2. Now when we are calculating In minus 2, then it comes out to be n minus 2 by In minus 4. Now same way In minus 4 when we are calculating, it comes out to be n minus 5 over n minus 4 of In minus 6. Like this when we are calculating it, and in the last if we are calculating I2, it comes out to be 1 by 2 of I0. And same way when we are calculating I1, it comes out to be I3 is 2 by 3 of I1. Now our purpose is to calculate I0 and I1. I0 is integral 0 to pi by 2 sin to power 0 x dx. This means we are integrating just a 1, and when we are integrating 1 between 0 to pi by 2, it gives us the value pi by 2. Now I1 is 0 to pi by 2 of sin x dx. And when we are taking its integration, then it comes out to be minus cos x, and between 0 to pi by 2, we are getting its limit as 1. This means I0 comes out to be pi by 2 and I1 comes out to be 1, and total when we are calculating, then In comes out to be 1 minus 1 by n into n minus 2 by n minus 2 into n minus 5 by n minus 4 up to, suppose we are getting this term. This means we have the even terms. So when we have even terms, we are getting it is 1 by 2 into I0 is pi by 2 when n is even. And when we are getting its value is, it comes out to be n minus 1 by n into n minus 3 by n minus 2 up to 2 by 3 when n is odd. So this is the reduction formula which is basically used in most of the physical problem and in calculating the powers of the sine function. Suppose we have to calculate the value of the integral 0 to pi by 2 of sin of 6 x dx. So directly by using this formula we can calculate the value, because n is 6, so we are applying this, it comes out to be 5 by 6, which is this formula, then 3 by 4, which is the next term, into 1 by 2, when we reach to the 1 by 2, then we multiply it by the pi by 2. So in general, in one line we got the solution as, this is the solution of this one, 5 pi by 32. So this is the solution directly we are getting if we have the value as 0 to pi by 2 of sin 6x. Suppose we have to calculate the value of 0 to pi by 2 of sin of 7x dx, then by using this n minus 1 by n, means 6 by 7. Next term is n minus 3 by n minus 2 means 4 by 3, 4 by 5. Then we have 2 by 3. And if we reach to the 2 by 3, this means we are here. So, formula terminated. So, this value is directly comes out to be, we have 16 by 35. So, this is the way directly we are able to calculate the integral from 0 to pi by 2, either in terms of sine, power, whether it is odd power or even power. So, directly by using, we are getting the solution of this. Now, if we have to take the integral from 0 to pi of sine 5x, suppose. Now, easily by using the definite integral property, we know that we are able to write down sine of pi minus x is same as, then we are reducing it to the pi by 2 form. And that directly we are getting, because it is an odd function, we are getting it as a 0 value. So, it is helpful in finding the physical properties and the values in the physical domain. Now, we are calculating the formula for cos. Suppose In is integral of cos to power nx, we do not know what is the value of n. So, in general, when we are integrating it, we assume that n should be greater than or equal to 1. Now, when we are integrating it, then as we have done right now, we are writing it as cos of n minus 1 x into cos x dx. When we are using this formula, again integrating by parts, the integral of cos x is sin x into this function as it is, minus we are taking the derivatives. So, it becomes n minus 1 of cos n minus 2 into sin. Now, when we are taking again writing it, it comes out to be sin x into cos of n minus 1 x plus n minus 1 of cos n minus 2 x into 1 minus cos square x dx. And when we are adopting this formula, it comes out to be sin x into cos of n minus 1 x plus n minus 1 of, we are getting first formula is cos n minus 2 x. So, it comes out to be I n minus 2 minus next term is n minus 1 of I n. So, when we are taking it on this side, we are getting that I n comes out to be, it is the formula sin x into cos of n minus 1 x divided by n plus n minus 1 by n of I n minus 2. So, this is the formula, reduction formula for cos to power n. Now, again the important use of this is in the physical problem, in calculating the area, volume. So, when we are calculating 0 to pi by 2, then again at 0, this cos is, sin is 0 and at pi by 2 cos is 0. So, I n comes out to be n minus 1 by n of I n minus 2. Again applying the same way as we have done for the sin, I n minus 2 is n minus 3 over n minus 2 of I n minus 4. Now, adopting the same methodology, we are getting I 3. If we are calculating I 3, I 3 comes out to be 2 by 3 of I 1, I 2 is 1 by 2 of I 0. Now, if we are calculating I 0, I 0 is integral 0 to pi by 2 of cos to power 0 x dx, which is nothing but pi by 2. If we are calculating I 1, it is integral of cos x dx, and we know that it is nothing but sin, and integral of sin is 1 at pi by 2. So, this means if we are calculating these values and substituting, again we are getting the formula as I n equal to n minus 1 by n into up to 2 by 3 if n is odd. And this formula is terminated to n minus 1 by n into n minus 3 by n minus 2 up to 1 by 2 into pi by 2 if n is even. So this is giving you the same formula, either it is sine function or the cosine function, but the main importance of this is when we are finding the physical application, like the area of the curve or the length of the curve or the volume of the curve or the surface area or the physical properties like center of gravity, moment of inertia and etc. for finding the solutions. So normally when we have any function of this type, then we are using the directly the reduction formulas from 0 to pi by 2, because normally we are calculating the integral in its principal domain for the trigonometric functions, and easily we can transform if it is 0 to 2 pi by applying the integration properties from 0 to pi by 2. And then applying directly the formula in just one line, we know the solution and we are able to calculate what is the value of this function. Now suppose we have to calculate, or its application is in solving most of the integrations, like suppose we have to solve this integral. Suppose we have to solve this integral 0 to a. Now if we have to solve this integral, in this integral if we are taking that, it is given that let we are taking x is a sin theta. If we are supposing x is a sin theta, then dx is a cos theta d theta. And when we are putting the limit, when x is 0, sin theta is 0 means theta is 0. When x is a, then sin theta is 1 means theta is pi by 2. So this integral reduces to 0 to pi by 2. A sin theta to power 7 divided by under root of a square minus a square sin square theta into a cos theta d theta. Now when we are solving this, we are getting a cos theta, this is also a cos theta, so this cancel out, directly we have this as a to power 7 0 to pi by 2 sin of 7 theta d theta. Now since this power is 7, and when we are solving directly by applying this formula, we are getting its value as a to power 7, this is 6 by 7 into 4 by 5 into 2 by 3. Now when we are solving this directly, we are getting the value of this as 16 a 7 by 35. So this is the direct integration of this, and we can easily reduce the function and calculate the values in a simpler form. Now suppose we have the some difficult form of the trigonometric forms, like if we have to integrate, suppose we have to integrate the function from 0 to pi of under root of 1 minus cos x divided by 1 plus cos x of sin square x dx. If we have to integrate this function, now in this case we know the geometric properties of the this function. We know that easily we are able to write down this as 1 minus cos x means 2 sin square x by 2. Under root when we are taking, we have under root 2 sin of x by 2. 1 plus cos x is easily we are able to write down 2 cos square x by 2. And when we are writing sin x, we know that it is 2 times of sin x by 2 cos of x by 2 whole square dx. Now if we are writing this thing, then it is 1, 2 cancel out, cos square cancel out. So it is 2 times of root 2, 0 to pi, and we have sin cube of x by 2 dx. Now if we are putting x by 2 as t, then we have dx by 2 is dt. So, this becomes 4 times of root 2 0 to pi by 2 sin cube of t dt. And when we are solving it, we are getting its value as easily it comes out to be 4 root 2 into 2 by 3. And this is the solution of this function. So, this means easily we are able to calculate the function as a solution, and it comes out to be 8 root 2 by 3. So, this is the simplest way of solving the complex integrals, which we easily we are not able to calculate, but by the limits and directly applying the formulas of sine and cosines, easily we are able to calculate it. Suppose now we have the function of the form, if it is this form, let we have the function of the form 0 to infinity dx over a square plus x square to power n. We have to solve the integration. If we are substituting x as a tan theta, we know that when we are substituting x as a tan theta, then a square plus x square easily we are able to convert in the form of secant theta. Now, by substituting this, dx becomes a sec square theta d theta, and when we are substituting x as 0, theta becomes 0, x as infinity, then theta becomes pi by 2. So, this is 0 to pi by 2. Dx is a sec square theta d theta, and this term is a square plus a square tan square theta, means we have a to power 2n into secant n theta d theta. So, when we are solving it and calculating it, we are getting directly this function as this comes out to be 1 by a to power 2 n minus 1, and now this when we are writing it is secant of 2 n minus 2 or cos of, we have 0 to pi by 2 of cos of 2 n minus 2 theta d theta. So, directly as we know that this is an even function, so directly when we are substituting the value, we are getting 1 by a to power 2 n minus 1 into this is 2 n minus 3 over 2 n minus 2, 2 n minus 5 over 2 n minus 4, and goes to the 1 by 2 into pi by 2. So, this is the easiest way of finding the solution. So, the most important part is we are reducing sine or cosine forms from 0 to pi by 2, and then easily we are able to calculate that in the form of the powers. Now, suppose it is given or we have to solve that. Now, we have the sum forms which are depending on this one, as let I n equal to 0 to a of a square minus x square to power n of dx. We have to solve this integral and we have to find out what should be the its reduction formula. Now, if we have this form, one is easily we can write down that x is suppose a sin theta, then dx is a cos theta d theta, and when we are substituting the limit at x equal to 0, theta is 0, at x equal to a, theta is pi by 2. So, I n is comes out to be 0 to pi by 2 a square minus a square sin square theta to power n into a cos theta d theta. So, when we are taking it, it comes out to be a to power 2 n plus 1, because a to power 2 n is common from here, and plus 1, this is 1 minus sin square theta means cos square theta. So, we have into integral of 0 to pi by 2 cos of 2 n plus 1 theta d theta. And easily when we have this one, easily we can write down that it comes out to be a to power 2 n plus 1. Applying the integral of this, it is 2 n over 2 n plus 1 into 2 n minus 2 over 2 n plus minus 1 and goes up to the 1 by 2 by 3. So, this is the solution of this integral. So, it is easier to calculate if we have this type of the form, how to solve this and to integrate it in a proper form. Now, firstly, we have solved when we have only the sine functions, then we have the form of the only cos functions. Now, suppose if we have the product of sine and cosine forms, then how to solve this integral? Now, we have the forms of the form of suppose we have sine of integral and cos of integral. This means we have the multiple of sine m and cos n. In this case, if we have the integrals in a form of sine and cosine both, then we have to solve it in the form of a product of those functions. When we are solving the product of these functions, now it depends on there are the different ways of solving it. M is the power of sine function, n is the power of the cos function. When we have the powers of sine and cos functions, so one way is we are going on reducing the powers, and when we are going on reducing the powers, then ultimately we have reached to the function of either in terms of sine or cosine. So it is easier whichever is least power. So in this case, we have the cases either m is less than n, or m is greater than n, or m is equal to n. If m is less than n, this means easily firstly we are reducing the powers of m, and then we are coming to the powers of n only. This means if m is less than, then we are taking the derivative of m. So we are going on reducing the powers, and we are considering the functions in such a manner that m should be reduced first and then the n we are going on reducing. But if m is greater than n, then firstly we are reducing n and then going to the m powers. So in this manner, if we are taking it, so what we are writing it? We are writing it as sine of, because we are considering that as a power of the function. So we are writing it as sine of m minus 1 x into sine x into cos of nx dx. This means simply we are writing sine m as m minus 1 into 1. So it becomes this function. So now we are considering this as a first function and a second function. So integrating by parts, we are getting it as, we are taking this function as it is and the integration of this. Integration of this gives you, when we are putting cos x, so it is sine of m minus 1 x into integral of this is minus of cos n plus 1 x over n plus 1. Now we are taking a, because we are integrating by parts, then it becomes plus of 1 over n plus 1 into, we are taking a derivative of this, so it is m minus 1, and integral of cos of n plus 1 x into derivative of this is sine of m minus 2 x into cos x dx. This means if we are simplifying this, it comes out to be imn is equal to minus of sine of m minus 1 x into cos of n plus 1 x divided by n plus 1. Plus, when we are writing this function, then it becomes m minus 1 over n plus 1. Now, this is sine of m minus 2 into cos of n plus 2. So, we are writing it as sine of m minus 2 x into cos n x into cos square x as 1 minus So when we are solving it further, we are getting it as minus of sin m minus 1 x into cos of n plus 1 x divided by n plus 1 plus of, when we are writing this term, it comes out to be m minus 1 over n plus 1. Now when we are having the first term is I of m minus 2 n, and the second term is minus of m minus 1 over n plus 1 of I m n. Now we are taking this term on this side and adding these, we are getting this as when we are taking it I m n equal to, when we have this term n plus 1 cancel out and this becomes m plus n. So it is minus of sin of m minus 1 x into cos of n plus 1 x divided by m plus n. Then we have plus of m minus 1 over m plus n into I m minus 2 n. This means we have done in this, originally it is sin m power and cos n. So we reduce this by reduction formula m power by 2. This means we are reducing the sin power, and then in this manner we are going on reducing all the powers of sin first and then we are coming to the cos powers. So if we are doing in this manner and calculating the reduction formula for this value from 0 to pi by 2, when we have 0 to pi by 2, this value gives us the 0 value, because at 0 sin is 0 and at pi by 2 cos is 0. So this factor gives us the 0 value. So total function becomes I m n equal to m minus 1 over m plus 1 of I by m minus 2 n. Now same way, if we are writing I m minus 2 n, this becomes m minus 3 over m plus n minus 2 of I of. So in this manner, if we are going on, if we are calculating I 2, I 3 of n, then it comes out to be, when m is 3, so it comes out to 2 by m n plus 3 of I 1 n. And when we are calculating I 2 n, it comes out to be 1 over n plus 2 of I 0 n. Now we have to calculate what is I 1 n. I 1 n means we have to calculate the value from 0 to pi by 2 of sin x into cos n x dx. Now we know that this is a simple, when we have this function, we are putting cos x as t, then the integral of this comes out to be minus of cos to power n plus 1 over n plus 1, and between 0 to pi by 2 it gives the value as 1 over n plus 1 directly. Now when we have the I 0 n function, I 0 n means 0 to pi by 2 of cos n x dx, and right now we have done the reduction formula for cos n x. So when we are solving it and substituting it here, we are getting the reduction formula as I m n is equal to, when we are substituting this, it comes out to be m minus 1 over m plus n into m minus 3 over m plus n minus 2, like this if we are coming up to this part. So this is up to 2 over n plus 3 into 1 over n plus 1. If we have m is a odd, it is immaterial n is even or odd any term, because we are restricted only on the m values. Then we have m minus 1 over m plus n इंटू एम माइनस थ्री ओवर एम प्लस एन माइनस टू अप टू वी आर रीचिंग टू दिस पार्ट विच इज वन ओवर एन प्लस टू. नाउ वी हैव टू रिड्यूस द पावर्स ऑफ दिस वन एंड इट गिव्स अस एन माइनस वन बाय एन इंटू एन माइनस थ्री ओवर एन माइनस टू गोज अप टू द टू बाय थ्री. एंड दिस फॉर्मूला इज एप्लीकेबल वेन एम इज इवन एंड एन इज ऑड. दिस मीन्स वेन एम इज इवन देन वी हैव द टू पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रेक. फर्स्ट इज वेन एन इज ऑड एंड वेन एन इज इवन देन दिस रिड्यूस टू अप टू वन ओवर एन प्लस टू देन वी हैव एन माइनस वन अपॉन एन एंड गोज टू द वन बाय टू इंटू पाई बाय टू इफ एम एंड एन बोथ आर इवन. सो दिस इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट रिडक्शन फॉर्मूला बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द फिजिकल इंटरप्रिटेशन कम्स इन द पावर्स ऑफ साइन एंड कोसाइन. सो इजली बाई यूजिंग दिस रिडक्शन फॉर्मूला वी कैन कैलकुलेट द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द फिजिकल phenomenas and easily able to calculate the integrals in terms of area and volume. Now suppose we have to calculate the value of sin 5x into cos. Now in this case if we have to calculate directly by using this formula because m is odd so we are using the first formula. It comes out to be 4 by addition of these two. This means it comes out to be 4 by 11. Next term is 2 by 9 and when we reach to this one into 1 over 7. So directly we have this as a value of this solution. Now if we have to calculate the value of 0 to pi by 2 of sin 5x into cos of 7x dx again as m is odd so we are using again the first formula and in the first formula it comes out to be 4 by 12 into 2 by 10 into we are here 7 means 1 by 8. So this is the formula when we have the this type of the form. Now suppose we have the form as 0 to pi by 2 sin 6x into cos 7x dx. Now in this case m is even, this means we are here, but n is odd so we have to use this formula and it comes out to be 5 by 13 into 3 by 11 into we reach to this part means 1 by 9. Now we are reducing this, it comes out to be 6 by 7 into 4 by 5 into 2 by 3. So this is the solution if we have this type of the function. Now if we have to calculate 0 to pi by 2 sin 6x cos 8x dx. Now in this case m and n both are even, this means we are on this side. And when we are calculating this function, it comes out to be 5 by 14 into 3 by 12 into 1 by 10. So we reach up to this stage, then we are coming to this one, 7 by 8, 5 by 6 into 3 by 4 into 1 by 2 into pi by 2. So easily just in one lines, we are easily able to calculate the integrals of the product of sine and cosines and easily we are calculating the values which are coming to be by this formula. So most of the physical phenomena has mostly the powers in the form where sine and cosine both are in the terms and easily using this we are able to calculate the integral. Suppose now we have to solve this function.